It's a new year, a new decade, in fact, and that means New Year's resolutions. Promises we make to ourselves to break bad habits and form good habits. And given how much we use our iPhones every day, we shouldn't leave it out of them. So here are a few iPhone-related New Year's resolutions to think about. First, you have got to get those notifications under control. The main reason you use your phone too much, and you know that you do, is because it chirps and vibrates 200 times a day to grab your attention. Go to Settings, Notifications, and go through each app one by one. Turn off the sounds and banners for any app that doesn't require your immediate action. Consider turning off notifications entirely for most of your apps, especially social media. You're going to check Instagram on your own. You don't need a notification every time someone likes a picture of your latte art. Next, start making regular backups. Start by making sure iCloud Backups is turned on. Go to Settings, your Apple ID, iCloud, and then scroll down and make sure iCloud Backups is enabled. But iCloud Backup doesn't necessarily save everything. Once a month, plug your iPhone into your computer and use iTunes or Finder in macOS Catalina and make a full encrypted backup. Phone disasters happen every day, and if anything happens to your iPhone, you'll be glad you have a full backup. Maybe the most important resolution you can make is to start taking password security seriously. Every single site and service you use should have a unique password that is hard to guess. Millions of people get their security cameras accessed, their financial details stolen, and their social media accounts taken over because they reuse passwords. Don't be one of them. The best thing you can do is to start using a password manager. We like 1Password or LastPass, but there are other good ones too. Password managers make it easy to log in and fill out forms and help you use complex and unique passwords for every account you have. On your most critical accounts, like your Apple ID, Google account, bank and credit card accounts, or any sort of online storefront like Amazon or Steam, you should enable two-factor authentication. And I suggest using a code generator app like Authy instead of text messages. Having good password security doesn't have to be a hassle, but you do need to take action to set up a password manager, enable two-factor authentication, and change those reused passwords. So don't wait. Finally, maybe it's time to start thinking about using family sharing on your Apple account. It lets up to 6 people share App Store and iTunes purchases, iCloud storage, and subscriptions like Apple Arcade or Apple TV Plus. You get to decide which features and services you want to share and which you don't. All of Apple's new services support family sharing too. Maybe you don't want to pay $5 a month for Apple Arcade for yourself, but for 6 people, well, that changes the math a bit, doesn't it? Just open Settings, tap your Apple ID at the top, then Family Sharing. That's where you'll add or remove family members and decide which services you want to share. This year, as you resolve to eat healthier or lose a few pounds, don't forget about the habits of your digital life. We use our iPhones dozens of times a day, and we should make an effort to use it better.